My word, what a foul mouth. Slap one of these on ya. Let's learn the fun side story of Rebetiko, the music of Greece's Hashish singers. World War I, the Great War, the war to end all wars. Until 20 years later. But whatevs, the big war at the time. Most of you may recall that Germany got worked pretty famously in that war. But you might not remember the old sick man of Europe. This was the nickname for the Ottoman Empire, which had been slowly declining for centuries and was on the losing side of the war. The winners audaciously seized Ottoman territory in the Middle East, lush with the new lifeblood of the industrial 20th century, oil. In steps this handsome fella, Mustafa Kemal, known in later years as Ataturk, or Father of the Turks. Mustafa had a plan to bring the wheezing bag of Ottoman bones back to glory, and the key was westernization. Ataturk took power, continuing the fight against the occupiers and modernizing the country. Anything seen as backward was abolished. The monarchy, the Arabic alphabet, any Islamic influence on the government. This was a time of radical change, and the new state needed a new name, Turkey. Ataturk inherited an ethnically and religiously diverse territory, but he was a proponent of nationalism, and of course, father of the Turks. And nationalism, in its more toxic variety, proposes drawing a clean little border around your nation. Us in, them out. Well, you clever students of history may have already guessed what happens next. Ethnic cleansing and genocide, largely targeted at Armenians and Greeks. Though Ataturk's direct role in these atrocities is subject to debate, many of these happened during his regime. The wider world looked on in horror, and eventually hostilities ended with the 1923 Treaty of Lausanne, in which it was agreed that minority populations would be exchanged between Greece and Turkey. Refugees poured into Greek cities and created a poverty-stricken underclass. Deep in the urban underbelly of red light districts, criminal elements and the newcomers mixed, creating Rebetiko music, a sorrowful soundtrack for the denizens of these neighborhoods. The themes of these songs focused on life in the slums and the mangas or tough guy subculture. Even decades before the refugees arrived, Greek newspapers complained of the presence of these hoodlums. Once again in our city, we have gradually begun to see the wild faces, glowering eyes, and fearsome waxed mustaches of hard men who frequent the cobblestoned alleys and coffee shops, with one sleeve of their overcoat hanging provocatively from the shoulder, talking tough or singing a song about God and fate. While other newspapers spoke out against cafes with obscene dances, immoral scene, and women naked to the knee, heavens! With the arrival of the refugees from Turkey, Eastern melodies accompanied lyrics about gambling, jail, prostitution, and copious references to the euphoria of using heroin and hashish. For example, one song says, I was betrayed by two hard men and arrested on the boat. I had sewn into my jacket two sachets of black hashish, and packed into my false heels was heroin up to the brim. Well, another song goes like this. I was born among us, and among us I shall die. And may the hashish plants grow over my grave. Their devotion to these substances was reflected in their use of Muslim religious words co-opted into their slang. As hashish smokers, they were dervishes, or holy men. And the hashish cafe was known as the teke, or monastery. But not everyone was a fan. Much like the crusade in the 1990s to slap a parental advisory label on CDs, polite society disdained Rebetiko and its singers, fearing its wider influence. A larger cultural battle was playing itself out here. Greece had been going through its own nationalist growing pains and faced a dilemma. as the supposed birthplace of Western culture. What was to be done with all the Eastern influence acquired over half a millennium of Ottoman domination? Not surprisingly, high society favored the West, and Rebetiko, with its degenerate topics associated with hedonistic Eastern cultures, was a no-go in their vision for the country's future. Nevertheless, the manga's ideals of rejecting respectable status and living life to the fullest were intoxicating to vast swaths of Greek society, and the music became extremely popular. But every good party has to come to an end. And our party pooper was this guy, Ioannis Metaxas. The 1930s were prime time for right-wing dictators, and since fascists tend to be spoil sports, concerned with cultural purity, Metaxas identified public enemy number one, Rebetiko and its grimy lyrics. Metaxas went on a censorship spree in 1937, with new songs needing to be submitted for approval by the government. While he dealt a pretty significant blow to this cultural phenomenon, because love the police just doesn't have the right ring to it, the memory of the Hashish songs lives on. Some people are just so concerned with how culture should be rather than with how it is, which is always a losing battle. If only Metaxas had just chilled out, man, and had a long drag of Hashish. So remember, history isn't just kings and dates. It's the story of you and me, just in different times and in different circumstances. One big soap opera, and we should learn it that way. And of course, like and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram. Join the conversation on Reddit. And t-shirts are being prepped for our patrons. So sign up at patreon.com/funsizehistory. We'll get you some swag.